Welcome to another glimpse at TMS WEB Core Origin 1.4. Today, I would like to introduce the support for FaunaDB. FaunaDB is a rather new database. You might have seen the nice logo and the name written in this wonderful font. However, let me give you some features of FaunaDB. The number one advantage of using FaunaDB is it is serverless. It means you need no hardware, no maintenance, no backup, no licenses. Everything is being dealt with by FaunaDB. Of course, you need to subscribe to some sort of database subscription, but you don't need any hardware with licenses like Windows, backup software, all that kind of stuff. You don't need it. Everything is handled by the people from FaunaDB. That makes it ubiquitous, meaning you can access it everywhere on any device. And another great feature of FaunaDB is GraphQL, which is a new query language that gets more and more popularity. It is based on JSON, and that means it is very flexible, and it also tries to get rid of all the disadvantages that you have with SQL. How popular is it really? Well, big companies like Nextdoor, if you live in the United States, you probably heard of Nextdoor because it is one of the big social sites like Facebook or Twitter. Nextdoor handles communications between neighbors living in the same area. And all these other big companies use it already for their production databases. Fear not using it, because as any database in TMS Web Core, you can use it with a TDataSet infrastructure. So even if it is GraphQL database with a completely new query language that you might not know yet, you can use a TWEB FaunaDB client dataset to connect to the database. You use a TWEB data source to connect your controls on the form to the database, and then you can use a TWEB DB grid, a TWEB DB edit, controls that you've known for years. TMS provides you with a great example to learn about the new technology. The documentation gives you explicit instructions how to create the database on the FaunaDB side, how to create your user account, and how you can get started without paying any fees or anything. So there is a free package that allows you to test all the features in detail. After going through all the steps in the documentation, you're able to run this demo. This is the task example that has been used for many of the other databases that are included as part of TMS Web Core. It makes transition to this new database much easier. As you can see here, we have a FaunaDB client dataset. And if we look at the object inspector, you have the events for this dataset that you're used to after open, the most important one, so you can update your visual controls on the form. You also have an on error if the connection to the database doesn't work. And of course, you need to specify which collection or which table is responsible for the login information that you see right here. So that is something that is really great. User authentication and authorization is part of FaunaDB databases. That is nothing that you need to code into your databases. And if you might think, oh, where is the database? Because I just see the table users. I don't see any connection to a database. I also don't see a database connection in particular. Well, that is intentional, because as you can see here, you have the client key. And this is something that FaunaDB, or the user interface of the database, delivers to you. The client key identifies you as the administrator of the database, gives you access to the database, and the client key is not for all of the databases that you have in your FaunaDB account. No, it's for one specific database. Looking at the source code, in order to log in to your database, you simply have to call the method login. And for that to work, you need to assign the client key. The client key can be specified in the edit control on the form, and you provide a username and a password. And then, of course, as it is the client dataset that execute this action, you have to implement two events. I already mentioned those events. If the login is successful, after open is executed, and if there is an error, on error is executed. Looking at after open, You see, what happens is we enable the tasks, and if there is a logout or an error, we disable the tasks. What happens on the user interface side is that enable task displays the lower part of the dialog and disable tasks only displays the upper part. Let's run the application before we look at further implementation details. Here you see only the upper part of the dialog is visible. The API key is already included. Your demonstration most likely will show this key. I chose an approach to make certain that this key is not visible. And I also created the user account for John Doe with a password of 1234. So I log in, and after connecting to the database, all the data from the database is being shown inside of a grid. And now I can add a new task. It is due on May 30th. And on May 30th, I have to hand in CodeRage abstract, CodeRage Germany, that is. And I update, and you can see it's new. And I can also say, okay, it is urgent, update, and the status changes to urgent. You can navigate with a DB navigator. So all the database features are working as you're used to. You didn't have to write any GraphQL or anything that you're not already used to. Everything is wrapped in the known T dataset infrastructure. If we log out, as expected, the lower part of the form disappears and the login screen appears again. Just to confirm that there's nothing new happening, so if you, for example, click on new task, the DB client dataset gets an insert, and you add your field values using field by name, then you call post, and of course you manipulate your user interface that the correct edit control is enabled and focused. For update, the same thing, it's a simple post. For delete, you call the delete method of the client dataset. And did I forget anything? Yeah, cancel, of course. With cancel, you call cancel so that all your changes are being ignored and reverted back to their original values from the database. The whole interaction of the grid is automatic as you use from the VCL. All the graphical controls, of course, have a data source property which you connect to this data source, and the data source is connected to the data set. This is done in code and not at design time, but you could do it as design time by simply selecting the data set. I hope you're just as excited as I am to be able to develop web applications with TMS Web Core with one of the most modern database systems around, FaunaDB. Let's jump right into it by downloading the trial of TMS Web Core version 1.4.